Helen Thompson. I'm a producer here at Science News. This year, for our year-end issue, we decided to ask our beat writers what they're excited to cover next year. And here's what they said.
I'm Emily Conover. I'm the physics writer for Science News. So the big discovery this past year was the detection of gravitational waves by the LIGO experiment. And we expect to see more from them in the coming year, so that's really exciting. Everyone is super pumped about gravitational waves right now. Well, particle physics is sort of in a weird state right now. It's a little bit of, people are starting to get anxious. And we know that there's a lot of stuff that's still unexplained in particle physics. Like, we don't know what dark matter is, the stuff that makes up a large portion of the matter in the universe. So scientists are starting to look in some more out-of-the-way corners for new physics.
Hi, I'm Tina Hessman-Say. I'm the molecular biology reporter for Science News magazine. CRISPR is a hot new molecular biology tool that you may have heard of because everybody is using it to edit genomes. According to most scientists, CRISPR can do anything. But it's not exactly true, but it can do a lot of stuff. In 2017, you can expect, for instance, to see clinical trials for cancer starting out with CRISPR, and also possibly bringing CRISPR back to its roots to combat viruses like HIV and hepatitis.
I'm Thomas Sumner. I'm the Earth and Environmental Sciences reporter for Science News magazine. About 66 million years ago, there was a devastating disaster on Earth, and about 3/4 of all plant and animal species got wiped out in a geologic instant. And that's been a mystery for decades, and you might have heard in school that everything died from big space rock impact, but not everybody believes that. And so to help answer that question, a team of researchers has gone back to the scene of the crime off the coast of Mexico, this giant 200 kilometer across crater called Chicxulub. They dropped 3 giant kind of legs into the sea, jacked themselves out of the water so they had a stable platform, and then drilled straight down into what's called the Peak Ring. It's this ring of mountains within the crater itself. So this drilling project and a lot of other research projects regarding this horrible extinction event have already told us a lot, but there are some big questions that are remaining, and a lot of the findings are just making those questions even bigger. So 2017 is going to be interesting one way or the other, whether or not we really saw what killed the dinosaurs.
Hi, I'm Megan Rosen, and I'm a staff reporter at Science News. So I cover everything from robots to dinosaurs, but this year I spent a lot of time focusing on the Zika virus outbreak. So this year we've learned a lot about how Zika virus can affect a baby's brain and body, but we don't yet have a vaccine. I think the earliest we can expect to see a vaccine for Zika is in 2018 or 2019. Vaccines have already started working their way through human safety trials, so I'm hoping that we see some results in 2017. 2 or 3 years might seem like a long time to wait for a Zika vaccine, but in terms of vaccine development, it's a really short timeline.
I'm Laura Sanders, and I'm the neuroscience writer here at Science News. One of the most interesting new technologies that I've come across this year is called neural dust, and it's these tiny crystals that scientists can implant, so far just in animals, but they can eavesdrop on nerve cell behavior, and ultimately they hope can even control nerve cell behavior. Scientists are coming up with all of these different ways to really figure out what brain cells are doing and influence them in a way that might actually help people.
Hi, I'm Christopher Crockett, and I'm the astronomy writer at Science News. It's always a really cool year to be writing about astronomy. We're always discovering new things, and I'm sure 2017 will be no different, but there are a few things coming up that I'm really excited about. The Juno mission's at Jupiter, and it's been there since July, but now it's going to really start doing its regular science, mapping the interior of Jupiter, getting a 3D picture of what the biggest planet in our solar system is like on the inside. But I think one of the coolest things going on in the solar system this year is the end of the Cassini mission at Saturn. After almost 20 years in space and over a decade at Saturn, the mission's coming to an end. The spacecraft is going to dive into Saturn, plunge into its atmosphere. It's going to be making measurements and transmitting data as long as it can until it's crushed to death.
These are just some of the stories we'll be tracking in 2017. Stay tuned to see if we're right. and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.